one of the many big political developments that we're talking about tonight. That's the coming together of the Samajwadi Party and the BSP for two bypolls in UP later this month. It is the first time in 23 years that the two parties have had any understanding. The last time they were actually in government together, but that went south pretty fast. Now, if this tie-up stays for 2019, and at the moment Mayawati says it's nothing to do with 2019, but if it does, it could be a potential game-changer.
They say all is fair in love and war and, well, in politics as well. Akhilesh Yadav and Mayawati have decided to join hands to try and win the Gorakhpur and Phulpur bypolls. And so, what brought this unlikely coalition together? Well, voter arithmetic for one. Take Phulpur. The constituency was a stronghold of the BSP before the 2014 elections. However, in 2017, the BJP won all assembly seats from here. An SP-BSP understanding here could stop dividing the Muslim vote and may give a boost to Dalit Muslim Yadav politics. However, in Bua and Babua coming together, Bhaiya, it seems, is left out.
Dalit Samaj ka har vyakti jo mahatvapurna hai, wo kehta hai ki ye galat faisla hai, har halat mein galat faisla hai. Samajwadi Party shuddh roop se dalit virodhi mani jati hai.
Sources meanwhile have told NDTV the Congress is likely to pull back its candidates for the two bypolls, which could further help the SP candidates, as all SP, BSP and Congress votes could likely consolidate. For the BJP, this is a must-win. They are happy with their performance in the northeast, but the defeat in Rajasthan is not forgotten. The two seats are prestigious since they have been vacated by none other than Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath and his deputy Keshav Prasad Maurya. And so it is attack from the word go. It's a do-or-die battle for all here. A win of the opposition here would strengthen the alliance and show the way for a non-Congress, non-BJP alliance. A loss for the BJP will mean the wave is waning, and ahead of 2019, that is not good news. An NDTV Bureau report.
Well, joining us on Left, Right and Centre tonight is Derek O'Brien, the Trinamool's Parliamentary Party leader in the Rajya Sabha and a member of Parliament, of course. Derek O'Brien, thanks for joining us. Lots to talk about tonight. Beginning with what you wrote for NDTV.com, something that Mamata Banerjee has also repeated today. You said that in August 15, 2019, Narendra Modi will not be addressing this nation from the ramparts of the Red Fort. You're saying don't extrapolate too much from the Tripura results. However, let me ask you first about Bengal. Aren't you just a little bit nervous that the BJP was able to pull off this win in your neighbourhood, in your backyard? Something you thought was impossible even 3 years ago has been made possible today.
No, the situation is completely different. Tripura and Bengal. Tripura was surrendered by the CPIM. You know, it was a beleaguered CPIM. Tripura were looking for a change. And CPM surrendered. Where is Bengal and where is Tripura? The total number of voters in Tripura is 25 lakhs. One of the smallest districts in Bengal is Howrah. We have 32 lakh voters in Howrah with two MPs from Howrah. We are talking about two completely different situations. So Bengal and Bengal, there is only one race on. Who will come second, third and fourth? And this is not arrogance, because Bengal, the Bengal two pillars of Bengal have been development and diversity. We won an election 1 year ago, just over a year ago, sweeping win. We won every by-election in Bengal. So Bengal, I think two states are already a done deal. One is Bengal and the other is Telangana. Okay, now, please understand, BJP are trying to hype this up, but let not the hype cloud, let's not forget the logic. They're trying to cloud the logic. Because if you really want to study the election results of elections in the last 6 weeks, you have to look at Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, bordering Haryana, those contiguous states and Chhattisgarh. In those four contiguous states, 75 seats, BJP have 71. As a student of politics, if you study those results, it's pretty clear that from the 71 out of 75, they will drop to something like between 15 to 20. This is not Trinamool numbers. You give this to any sophologist, and you all are the top channel when it comes to cephalology. You will, if you extrapolate that data, they are minus 50 in these four contiguous states. And we haven't even got to UP.
Derek,
you know what developments have happened. Now, over the weekend, there have been a lot of interesting developments.
No, exactly. No, I get your point that you can't overread one election result or the Northeast election results. I think they're very important. They've had an impact. They've galvanized the BJP cadre. But of course, what happens in the other state elections later this year is very, very important, if not more important. And we'll have to wait and see what happens. But you talked about what happened over the weekend. Now, what happened over the weekend also was Mamata Banerjee saying, and I'm quoting her here, that had Rahul Gandhi accepted my proposal for an alliance with the TMC and the Hill parties, Tripura would have been different. She says this is Congress negligence and she doesn't understand why the Congress said no to this. Can you elaborate on this? What exactly happened with the Congress here?
I can't elaborate on what exactly happened with the Congress, but I can tell you what my... what the chief of my party and the chairperson of the Trinamool Congress and the CM of Bengal, what she said was the truth. We wanted to try and work out an alliance and it didn't work out. But it didn't work out, it didn't work out. Now we have to look ahead. In looking ahead, what else happened on the weekend? Now it's pretty obvious in Andhra Pradesh. In Andhra Pradesh, the TDP have been in touch with us for a while. Let me also tell you, the TDP MPs were in the Trinamool office today in Parliament for about 45 minutes discussing with my colleagues what the contours of the Andhra Pradesh reorganization and what were the demands and trying to explain to us. That's the TDP. Then we had the TRS. TRS yesterday, Mamata Di and the Chief Minister of Telangana had a very, very useful, purposive conversation. By the way, I might as also tell you that Mr. Stalin of the DMK and Mamata Di, they also had a long 10-minute conversation yesterday. Now, you know, when in demonetization, Mamata Di was right up in the front. Who marched with Mamata Di on the 16th of November 2016?
One second, Derek. Because there are a couple
of... parties
who
marched.
No,
the National Conference marched. The National Conference marched.
You've given two news points here. One second, I have to ask you about that. You're saying, A, that the TDP has been in touch with the Trinamool Congress in Parliament. Has the TDP actually been in touch with you over opposition strategy in Parliament? They're technically still in the NDA.
See, for that you will ask the TDP. Let me also tell you, last week, the parliamentary party leader of the TDP and also the minister, I know he did invite Mamata Banerjee for his daughter's wedding. So, it was a wonderful wedding. And I had the good fortune of going there as a representative of the Trinamool and Mamata Banerjee to convey the good wishes, to convey our good wishes. So we are pretty much in good books with the TDP as well. And the TDP, from whatever I picked up in my 2 days in Hyderabad, both the TDP and the TRS, I think both of them pretty much know that the BJP is not a brand they want to be associated with in the 2019 elections. Shiv
so you
Sena
think the TDP is going to jump ship?
We all know.
You think
we all
the TDP
that the
will
Congress,
jump ship? They're serious about jumping ship?
I'm not a journalist, nor I'm a political analyst. I'm a Trinamool Congress spokesperson. But, Trinamool Congress and Mamata Di, before I made the Red Fort statement, Mamata Di discussed the Red Fort statement with me 1 day before that. So, I think you are giving me too much credit for that Red Fort statement. It was actually her idea, but it's a very nice statement. And it's a thought-out statement that in 2019, Prime Minister Modi will not address this nation from the ramparts of Red Fort simply because the numbers will just not add up. There are two... Now you might be saying, I'm indulging in big talk. Hold on. I don't mind waiting for another 10 days before I give you some more big talk. March 14th is another important day. Because on March 14th, let's take a very close look at what happens in the Phulpur Lok Sabha bypoll in UP. There's the other one, Gorakhpur. I will concede, as a student of politics, that Gorakhpur perhaps is a little better off for the BJP than Phulpur. But Phulpur is match on. In both these seats, the BJP have won by 3 lakh votes plus in 2014. I'm going to stick out my neck and say, Phulpur, it's a toss of the coin. It's very, very close. Now, there's one SP candidate being supported. The BSP will be supporting the SP candidate. Now, Congress have got a candidate in there. Maybe Congress too will support the SP candidate. And then we really have a match on. Now, if BJP, I think before Karnataka, this is a big match on the 14th of March. Now, the Congress too have a role to play. So just don't brush them off because they couldn't form the government in Meghalaya. The Congress have a big match on. They've got to win Karnataka. It's a one-on-one match there. They've got to do very, very well, and I'm sure they will in Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan in these states. So when we are looking at this, please don't say, or please don't assume that because all these loose federal parties have got together, that doesn't mean the Congress too don't have a role. Of course they have a role. Of course they've got to win their matches. The bottom line is you have to win your state.
But Derek, that's an important point that you've made, that don't think that the Congress is out of the picture essentially. However, you mentioned that Mamata Banerjee did have a conversation over the weekend with KCR. Okay. Now, KCR is on record as saying that he is now proposing this idea of a non-Congress third front, right? A non-Congress political front. And he says Mamata Banerjee has supported him on that. Has she?
Mamata Di has suggested the coming together of federal forces, at least in this Lok Sabha term, from about 2015, actually more like 2016, after the demonetization announcement. So that has been the suggestion she has made, that she's in touch with all the political parties. Why are you leaving out the NCP? Why are you leaving out the SP, the BSP, everyone? But the significant thing of the weekend, the significant thing of the weekend is the TRS coming on. It doesn't make a difference, you know, there's not about ego here. I suggested it, you suggested it, it really doesn't matter. But I think the reaching out yesterday of Mamata Di and the discussion she had with the Chief Minister of Telangana and the head of the TRS, I think these are very important signs. I think the TDP also is pretty much clear that they're not going to fight the 2019 elections in alliance with the BJP. These are all signs, and the Shiv Sena have gone on record. Plus, you've got the 17, 18 parties who've already been working together.
I'm asking whether Mamata Banerjee supports the idea of a political front without the Congress in it. In other words, do you all feel that the Congress doesn't have what it takes, in order to be able to lead an alliance, or Rahul Gandhi is not the right person? Has she supported KCR on this issue of a non-Congress front?
I think the focus here is very, very clear. The BJP has to go. And we all have to win our innings and score very well in each of these innings. I'm glad you haven't asked me the question of leadership, because that will also come after the election. Please understand this. Mamata Di, look at the track record.
Is she supporting the idea of a non-Congress front against the BJP? Yes or no?
You heard what she said when she spoke to the TRS chief yesterday. And I think there are a lot of federal aspirations, you know, except for defense.
No, can you clarify? Yes or no?
Is the Congress, as far as Mamata Banerjee is concerned, the idea of another
front without the Congress now taking hold?
You see, Nidhi, I don't think you should look at this front and that front, because that is oversimplifying it. It is oversimplifying it. I want to make one very crucial point here. Mamata Banerjee is a three-time union minister. She's got 40 years experience in politics. She's overthrown the left organically. Please understand this, organically, not like the way it was done in Tripura. Okay. Now, she has been an MP for 25 years. And now she's all set to, she's repeated the chief minister again. She got elected with a big margin. Now, people are looking at Mamata Banerjee. She's not going around with her CV and her bio data saying, call me, do this. People are looking at her as this binding force. She's not interested only in the chair. She is more interested for the nation. What do we do to ensure? Because BJP are now saying their focus is Bengal. If their focus is Bengal, Orissa and Kerala, well, our focus is Lal Kila.
All right. And importantly, you're basically not ruling out any political formation. You're not saying it should be a non-Congress front, or it should be a front that includes the Congress. You're saying it's basically an open scene. It's anything could happen.
Let me tell you about Bengal quite clearly, so you don't have any misunderstanding. 2019 or 2018, whenever the elections are announced, the Trinamool Congress is fighting all 42 seats in Bengal. all 42 seats in Bengal. Who stands, where stands, we don't know, but all 42 seats in Bengal. This much I can assure you and tell you now.
All right, no other assurances then
for the moment. CPM will stand, Congress will stand.
Okay, all right. All right, Derek O'Brien, thanks very much. Lots of news points there in what you said, and we're going to discuss those further tonight. Thanks very much for joining us. Thank you. Well, joining us on the program this evening, a terrific panel is here with us. We have in the studio with us Ejaz Ilmi, member of the BJP, Ghanshyam Tiwari, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. Also with us, Mr. K.C. Tyagi, spokesperson of the JDU, former member of parliament. B. Vinod Kumar, Lok Sabha MP of the TRS. Sushmita Dev of the Congress Party, a member of parliament from the Congress Party. And Mr. Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay, great to have you back with us after the Gujarat elections, journalist and author. Let me take this first question to Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay, because the politicians will then get in on it and you'll have to wait. You heard what Derek O'Brien was saying. It seems that Mamata Banerjee is keeping all her options open. Do you think, I'm asking straight up front, that a non-Congress, non-BJP front is possible? Is it possible to take on the BJP and Narendra Modi without the Congress?
I think a front will come up only in those areas where there is going to be massive division of votes. The parties which are trying to get together now, say Mamata Banerjee or say KCR, these are people who consider themselves dominant in their area of strength, where they do not require the need for any allies. Coming a day after the Tripura elections, I think it is a huge message from Mamata Banerjee that she does not require anybody to align with in Bengal, that it remains as strong a bastion as it always was for her in the last 6 or 7 years. Similarly, the other party. So I think what these people are saying is that let us try to go in for elections, get the maximum number of votes, number of seats in our pockets, and then after the elections, come to the negotiation table, and then let's see who has how many in his
or
her
kitty. But is that going to work? When you have when the BJP has a clear face and a face like Narendra Modi, and a disunited opposition comes together and then decides a face later, is that going to work?
I do not know. You know, it all depends that what is the issue or the set of issues with which Mr. Modi is going to go into 2019. Is he going to go on the basis of his quote-unquote achievements, or is he going to go on the basis of an overarching political idea? You know, if it is an overarching political idea, which at the moment can be possibly nothing but some kind of a form of Hindutva or Hindutva plus various issues. You already have triple talaq. They are already beginning to talk about the uniform civil code. There is an RSS-sponsored population control agitation, a yatra going on through the country. So these are the various things, you know, which we talk about. Polarization is
so
one word.
So you believe issues will matter?
So either, you know, depending on what Mr. Modi goes. I think what is going to happen, that for areas, you know, states like West Bengal or others, it is going to be very difficult for the BJP to go with a national issue, because there are people who are, the people are still looking at their own personal reasons, you know, their own personal betterment, which they might be able to see through the strong regional leaders.
Sushmita, let me just ask you though about Mamata Banerjee's criticism of how the Congress sort of threw away this possible alliance in Tripura. She says she had suggested it to Rahul Gandhi, he didn't listen to her. She believes the Tripura result could have been different. Does it, firstly, let's talk about that, you know, how you're looking at that criticism, and does it not worry the Congress just a bit that, you know, already potential allies are talking about keeping a distance from the Congress? Akhilesh Yadav has said it, the left has said it, now you have KCR talking about it, and Mamata Banerjee may as well.
See, Nidhi, I'll tell you something, that there was some talk of coalition, but clearly we had to ask our tribal leaders, we had to ask our PCC president, and we acted on their advice. And I don't think such a scathing remark was required, because for instance, when Mukul Rai went from Trinamool Congress to work in Tripura, he first poached on the Congress, some of the Congress leaders like Sudeep Barman and all, who later left for the BJP, and so did Mukul Rai. So I don't want to comment on that. There were certain set of circumstances which led us to take these decisions. And I don't want to judge Mamata Di for it, and neither should she judge us for what happened. But there were set of circumstances which led to that decision. I think that's where I would like to leave it when it comes to commenting on what she had to say about Rahul Gandhiji's decision.
What about the rest of it though? The fact that now, again, as I said, potential allies seem to be saying that they don't want to tie up with the Congress in 2019. I mean, this could all be hardball bargaining. Everyone's going to try and pitch themselves as the front runners, possibly for a leadership role, because they're all important regional leaders. But having said that, does it not concern the Congress that, you know, they're not rallying around Rahul, or they're not rallying around the Congress then as the central force?
See, Nidhi, to be very honest, politics is very dynamic. For me to say in March 2018 what's going to emerge in the next 6 months or the 8 months will not be possible. But I think the lowest threshold we need to look at positively is on many issues the opposition has united, whether it's in the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha. So there is a certain amount of consensus, but eventually there will be many factors when it comes to seat sharing, or when it comes to understandings. And I think I'm sure that some of our views will be reflected in our plenary vis-a-vis many issues which are being debated within the party. So I think let it evolve, and it would not be proper for me to give a definitive answer one way or the other, but options are open.
Well, the options are open for you, but I did wonder whether you at least were a bit concerned by the noises that are coming out from some of these parties, but we'll just get back to that. You know, KC Tyagi
ji, Nidhi, just 1 second. Did you ever think that BSP and SP will come together 6 months back?
No, absolutely. And we don't know how that's going to work out either. And let we can talk about that. Tyagi ji, aap ye bataye, that do you think, Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay was saying, dekhte hain ki issue kya hai? What is the issue that Mr. Modi sort of bases his campaign on? But this is also a very personality-driven politics now. Will the opposition succeed without a face to take on Narendra Modi? क्या आपको लगता है कि issues पे ही लड़ाई होगी?
नहीं, नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने और इंदिरा गांधी जी ने जिस तरह की politics की है, जिस तरह का campaign किया है, उसके बाद उन्हीं के मुकाबले का कोई एक ऐसा बड़ा चेहरा चाहिए. मुझे 1971 का याद है, जब मिसेस गांधी जीती हैं तो 382 सीटें उनको मिली, और सीपीआई, सीपीएम और डीएमके 25-25 30 सीटों की पार्टी रह गई. आज जो 2018 है उसमें अन्ना डीएमके, टीएमसी और कांग्रेस से लगभग बराबर बराबर हैं, और उत्तर प्रदेश में तो अपना दल इज ए बिगर पार्टी देन कांग्रेस पार्टी. तो अभी कोई चेहरा उस तरह का अगर नहीं होता है, उसी का परिणाम है. डेरिक ओबेरॉय ने कहा है कि नेता ऐसा होना चाहिए जो मुख्यमंत्री भी रहा हो, जो केंद्र में मंत्री भी रहा हो, जिसे राज्य और केंद्र में काम करने
पता नहीं किस नेता की बात कर रहे हो.
ममता जी
नहीं, मैं मजाक कर रही हूँ. ममता जी की कर रहे हैं.
दूसरा, विपक्षी एकता का केंद्र बिंदु दिल्ली होगा, हैदराबाद या कोलकाता. और तीसरा, जो केसीआर ने और ओवैसी ने एक बाजी बाजी में बैठ के जो बयान दिए हैं वो ये है कि कांग्रेस पार्टी भी फेल हो गई है एक अल्टरनेटिव देने में. तो ये थर्ड फ्रंट जो है, दिस इज मोर अगेंस्ट कांग्रेस देन अगेंस्ट बीजेपी, क्योंकि अभी तो इनको ये तय करना है. और कांग्रेस पार्टी के बारे में एनसीपी ने गुजरात चुनाव के बाद कहा, एसपी बीएसपी ने फेल किया. अगर एक एक सीट भी इन पार्टियों को दे गई होती तो आज वहां पे परसेंटेज ऑफ वोट के हिसाब से, नंबर के हिसाब से एक नॉन बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट होती वहां पे. तो कांग्रेस पार्टी इतनी इंटॉलरेंट पार्टी है कि जहां पर वो मजबूत है सीट शेयर नहीं करेगी. उसी का नतीजा है कि जहां जीत सकती थी कांग्रेस बंगलुरु में, वहां पर जेडीएस, वहां पर बीएसपी, वहां पर एसपी, वहां पे सीपीआई, वहां पे
गुजरात में एनसीपी, यहां त्रिपुरा में जो ममता बनर्जी ने बात करी.
त्रिपुरा के लिए तो वहां का बताना जा
रहा हूं. सो यू बिलीव इट्स अ नॉन स्टार्टर बेसिकली?
मतलब राहुल गांधी के नेतृत्व में तो आप किसी पार्टी के नेता,
मगर थर्ड फ्रंट उनके कांग्रेस के बिना चल सकता है?
नहीं, उस धुरी तो कोई बड़ी राष्ट्रीय पार्टी होनी,
यू नीड सम नेशनल पार्टी, नॉट
अ पार्टी होनी है अगर मोदी जी का थोड़ा बहुत भी मुकाबला करना है.
सो घनश्याम तिवारी, लेट्स बिफोर आई टॉक अबाउट द एसपी बीएसपी अलायंस इन पर्टिकुलर, यू नो अखिलेश यादव आल्सो हैज टॉक्ड अबाउट डिस्टेंसिंग हिमसेल्फ फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस, एंड ऑफ कोर्स थिंग्स कुड चेंज इन द नेक्स्ट वन ईयर इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम इन पॉलिटिक्स, बट वुड यू लार्जली अग्री विद द क्रिटिसिज्म दैट बोथ ममता बनर्जी हैव मेड, व्हाट केसी त्यागी इज सेइंग about the Congress's sort of very bad political instincts when it comes to stitching up alliances and adjusting with other parties? I mean, it was reflected even in your alliance in UP, which was a disaster.
Alliances can be a political response, could be an arithmetic response, or call from the people. What you are seeing in Uttar Pradesh today is an alliance which is emerging from the call from the people. The poor, the marginalized, the farmers, the backwards, Dalits, minorities have come together and say that we do not want a government that has a diabolical model of governance. So you would see that this alliance would get strengthened depending on what is the verdict that comes out of Phulpur or Gorakhpur. As far as thinking about a national alliance, we think about national alliance primarily in an arithmetic sense. What is more important is look at what is working right now. This year, BJP has not won a single bipole across four states. They lost Rajasthan, where Congress one-on-one, they were not strong enough.
The Congress took away seats from them in Rajasthan.
They lost Madhya Pradesh one-on-one, they were not strong enough. They lost Odisha, were not strong enough. They lost West Bengal. So one-on-one, BJP is unable to take the dominant force in that place because BJP has not delivered. And that is the formula of national alliance that will emerge. That does not matter which state you are talking about. There has to be one dominant force that takes on BJP, and the structure leader would emerge thereafter.
No, so what does that mean? Everything is, all cards are on the table.
It means that do not construct an alliance top down, construct it bottom up. Do not say find a mass leader that will take on Narendra Modi ji. Do not find a mass cadre that will take on Narendra Modi ji. Look at which parties are becoming dominant force in different regions to take on BJP on their case of poor delivery, because they are in power in 22 states, 21 states, and in every state.
So, are you saying the issue of who the face should be should only come later, which is what the TMC is saying as well?
Absolutely.
Let's talk about the leader later.
Absolutely. Challenge the BJP on the ground of governance, on the ground of demands people are making, rather than on the ground of popularity of Prime Minister Modi.
Okay. So, Ejaz, your first thoughts as the BJP on what is being said here, that the opposition's criticism seems to be, okay, well done, you did a great job in the Northeast, historic election, all of that is taken. But you have very crucial state elections which will really determine where we're going.
No, I agree with you. Every election is a very serious issue for the BJP. But also, I mean, it's not so simple to say you won Northeast. But look at the transformation, the tectonic shift that has happened. Overthrowing the left from the Marik Sarkar's government was no easy task. And also winning in two Christian majority states like Meghalaya and Nagaland, and if you extrapolate the vote share, number of seats contested, getting 35% to 40% of the Christian vote share. So it is complete negation of the church politics.
Two seats?
What? I'm talking about Nagaland, 12 seats out of 20 contested with a strike rate of 60. Extrapolate that. Two seats, because you contested, we are in contention only 8. So the fact is you're winning out there in the Christian majority state. So what is not selling now is that the BJP is anti-minority, anti-Christian, anti-Muslim.
Has the BJP been able to put a government together in Meghalaya because of its ideology, or because that it's got the power and the money to do it?
Unless, I see a lot of theory, I see a lot of extrapolation, presumptions, assumptions, permutations. I don't see a narrative that is there to challenge the BJP today. The only definitive that the BJP knows and understands is that where we are headed in the 19 election is under the leadership of the Prime Minister, who's delivered 11 new states since he's come to power in 14. So we understand that, and we have a long way to go. And issues like farmers' issue, we acknowledge the issues, and we are talking to sections of society without sitting on a high horse and saying that we don't care, because we do care. We ultimately, power comes with accountability and responsibility, and that is the reason. Unless the opposition has a narrative, and I don't see any narrative except for criticizing, demonizing, vilification of the Prime Minister on each and every issue. That is not working. The spokesperson of all these parties must understand that you can't keep on vilifying a person who's been elected by the people in a democratic fashion.
Well, Sushmita, I just want to ask you on the criticism that has been made about the Congress, and KC Tyagi's very pertinent comment in particular, that the Congress just, you know, doesn't know how to handle allies, that it just doesn't know how to make seat adjustments. And that happened in UP, you had problems in Gujarat, you know, now in Karnataka that could happen as well if you don't get your act together with the JDS and the BSP. Is that a fair criticism?
See, Nidhi, I'll tell you, with all due respect to Mr. Tyagi, 6 months back he was saying something else. So, and after 6 months from now, again, he may be saying something else. See, please understand that as we go into state elections, the factors are different. As we go into general elections, factors are different. And I'm repeatedly saying that how it's going to evolve or emerge. For instance, if Mamata Di is saying today she wanted an alliance, can Derek O'Brien tell us for sure that 6 months from now he'll want a pre-poll alliance or a post-poll alliance? You don't know. But one thing is for sure that there is a general feeling between all the opposition parties that BJP is destroying the fabric of this nation. The reasons they won in the Northeast, we know it very well. I need not comment on it.
Your allegations are totally belied by the mandate.
And it is definitely not a shift in the ideology to RSS.
Again, see, why would the Christian majority states vote for members
of the
BJP?
Interrupt.
So this allegation is belied over and over.
We know what the churches said and how your money was returned, that Mr. Alphonse took the money there. So, we know very well how it's happened, and let's see how long it lasts. And don't interrupt when I'm talking.
Yeah, but don't be a soothsayer and antaryami.
We will see before the general election. I mean, we know how many motorcycles crossed borders to Tripura. 1 year before, new motorcycles. Let's not get into it. Now, the question is, doesn't matter, be that as it may, Nidhi. All I'm saying is, KC Tyagi ji may criticize us today that we are not good at managing allies. But the fact is, recently we've seen a BJP MP in Maharashtra resign from BJP and join Congress also. There's a larger picture there. And please, I am sure that
If you had it in Gujarat with the NCP, or now in Karnataka, you need to have tactical alliances to cut your losses. Why should you have potentially like-minded parties cutting into your votes? That's the question. But Sushmita,
let me tell you, I just want to tell you, when we tied with the Samajwadi Party in UP, it all went terribly wrong. I mean, I did not...
because you got more seats than you deserve.
We know the record, what happened. So... No, but listen, I mean, that may be your opinion. The reason, it didn't work for us there. So, when we did make a tactical alliance, it didn't work. So, all I'm trying to say, in different states, the factors are very different. In Gujarat, when we decided not to tie up with some of the regional parties, it is because what our local leadership felt that they could pull it off without them. And you have to pay heed to that.
Okay, I'd like to go across
so
to
many
Mr.
Times
Vinod Kumar.
Why are you allowing state leaders to run their states?
Okay, Mr. Vinod Kumar, Lok Sabha MP of the TRS, has been patiently waiting. Mr. Kumar, you heard that the Trinamool Congress actually not committing itself to a non-Congress front at the moment. How do you think, though, that a non-Congress front would really work without some kind of a national party, a party with some national presence, cadre, etc., like the Congress, being part of that?
You see, for the last 70 years, right from the days of independence, we have seen either the Congress or the BJP ruling the country. So now the need of the hour is alternative politics. So that is the reason for which our chief minister, our leader, our party president, Mr. K Chandrasekhar Rao, had floated an idea of having a consortium of regional political parties initially, and eventually we can think of a platform for alternative politics for both against BJP and Congress as well. So that is the reason for which Mr. Rao has, day before yesterday, in his press briefing, he mentioned that the next alternative should be a non-Congress, non-BJP alternative to the nation.
But how will it work without the presence of a national party? How will it work without the presence of some national force? Because right now you're just a disparate group of your regional leaders who are all strong in your regions and your states, but you need something to hold you together.
You see, what happened in 77, immediately after emergency, within a span of 6 months, a party was floated and it came to power. That is Janata Party. So what we can expect, something may happen in the coming days, because the people of this country are vexed with the... both BJP and Congress. So we hope that in the coming days, all the regional political parties, and they are doing well, right from Mamata ji to KCR. So we hope that in the coming days, definitely there will be a consortium of the regional political parties, and where regional political parties are not powerful in the state of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, in some states, eventually some political
okay
may
so
take place. Some political
anything is possible in Indian politics. Ejaz has a quick comment here.
There's a lot of if, buts, yes, and mays, and hopes, and wants, and desires to move from state capitals to the lure of speaking from the Lal Killa, as Derek O'Brien said. So these are all aspirants and hopes and desires and pipe dreams without any narrative or without any central glue or without any issue may arise in 6 months' time. But let me tell my friend from the KCR's party, there's no emergency happening.
Look,
which happened in 77.
I'll tell you three issues right now.
Janta Party was formed.
But Ejaz, jobs, unemployment, farmer distress,
yes,
all of these are issues that
these
matter
are
to
issues,
people.
These are issues, yes. And the BJP is alive to the situation and is talking to sections and reaching out to them and working with the people on these issues. What? We're not saying that there's no issue. Yes, there's an issue which we're working upon. We're not shying from the reality.
Okay. One more. Let me get to Ghanshyam on this point about the SP and the BSP. How is this going to work? I mean, it's unthinkable that the parties have agreed to this. How is this actually going to work? Because this your sort of the voters whom you're targeting are very different. There must be a lot of discomfort even among leaders on the ground for this. How will this work?
Well, the nearest case study that I can suggest to you is, and Mr. K.C. Tyagi is here, is when RJD and JDU aligned on the call of Mr. Nitish Kumar. And there was a lot of studio talk, and especially sponsored by BJP's discussions, that this will not work on the ground. But when you really go to the ground and you realize that the social base is standing together against a leader who promises but does not deliver, against a regime that is primarily Samanti, which doesn't care about the poor, the backwards, the social base tells the political leaders that we are ready to unite for you, but you should represent our voice strongly. That Mahagathbandhan failed in Bihar, for me, is a failure of political morality. But I'll not go there. Primarily, coming to Uttar Pradesh, the social base is today saying the same thing. Yogi Adityanath made a stinging, very poor statement yesterday. He said
mongoose and snake.
Yes. Comparing the backwards, Dalits, to Chuchundar and Saap is a very poor statement. It's a third
UP ka muhavra hai Saap aur Nevle ka, to aisi koi iski mancha nahi thi. Ye muhavra hai.
It demonstrates a casteist, upper caste mindset of a rudimentary Thakur to say that backwards and Dalits are Saap and Chuchundar. This will backfire on BJP. When a leader and at the national level, when leaders become arrogant, they don't accept their mistakes. The Nirav Modi scheme scam is a classic case where the government has not even responded. They have just gone on a blame game of blaming UPA for a scam that happened right under their nose. So when leaders become arrogant, governments do not respond to the ground situation. Alliances from grounds up come together and political voices respond. SP-BSP alliance...
You really think SP and BSP will be able to have an understanding even in the general election? Right now, Mayawati is saying it's only for this bipole.
Well, as I said, we are responding to what is coming from the ground. If people today give us a strong voice to SP-BSP in Phulpur and Gorakhpur, if BJP is completely decimated in the bipoles, obviously this will be a strong voice that leaders cannot ignore.
Tyagi ji, agar Bihar mein ho sakta hai, UP mein kyun nahi?
Dekhi, Bihar mein aur UP mein jo social base tha, wo kamubesh ek jaisa tha. Backward, scheduled caste, minority, underprivileged, mahadalit. Uttar Pradesh ke andar pichle 25 saalon se chuke, us samay ye nahi tha, main tha Samajwadi Party mein Mulayam Singh ke saath. जब ये अलायंस बना है और कैसे टूटा है, और घनश्याम जी की शायद जानकारी ना हो, उत्तर प्रदेश में मुलायम सिंह यादव जी की सरकार ने दलितों को प्रमोशन में रिजर्वेशन नहीं मिलना चाहिए इसकी भी वकालत कर चुके हैं. और जो बीएसपी है, बेसिकली दिस इज रिजर्वेस्ट आउटफिट, तो वहाँ जमीन पर ये इतनी आसानी से उतरेगा. क्योंकि मैं समाजवादी पार्टी में रहते हुए मैंने देखा कि बहुत जगहों पर जो हरिजन एक्ट के तहत बहुत सारे समाजवादी पार्टी के कार्यकर्ता बंद हुए थे. ये आइडियल हो सकता था अगर ये प्रोग्राम ओरिएंटेड होता. एक दूसरा, ये तो सिर्फ राज्यसभा चुनाव के लिए. अभी तो माया जी ने ये भी कमिट नहीं किया है कि लोकसभा चुनाव तक चलेगा.
वो तो कहने की बात है.
हाँ, नहीं, मैं बता रहा हूँ आपसे.
इतना बिहार में शुरुआत राज्यसभा चुनाव से ही हुई थी. अगर आपको याद हो, बिहार में भी शुरुआत राज्यसभा चुनाव से हुई थी.
हर चीज में आप बिहार तलाश मत कीजिए. आपने कहा पॉलिटिकल मॉरलिटी का, तो पूरी की पूरी आरजेडी जेल में है. वो भी पॉलिटिकली
तो अलग बात है, लेकिन मैं ये जानता हूँ
अलग नहीं है. वो भी
बिहार में महागठबंधन का नीतीश कुमार जी ने बनाया था.
जो सुष्मिता जी कह रही थी, उसको आना चाहता हूँ. सुष्मिता जी, आई एम एड्रेसिंग टू यू. जब हम बिहार चुनाव जीत गए तो हम बड़े उत्साह में थे कि महागठबंधन को दिल्ली तक लाया जाए. नीतीश कुमार जी ने प्रफुल्ल महंता को बुलाया, जो पहले एजीपी के चीफ थे, मुख्यमंत्री थे दो बार के. कांग्रेस पार्टी से बार बार रिक्वेस्ट की, अजमल साहब दो दिन तक बिहार भवन में बैठे रहे और कांग्रेस पार्टी के लीडर्स ने ना तो अजमल साहब से, जिनके आज 16 MLA या 15 MLA जीत करके आए हैं,
सही बात,
और प्रफुल्ल मोहंता से अगर कांग्रेस पार्टी एडजस्टमेंट करती तो ना आज नॉर्थ ईस्ट में और ना आसाम में सैफरन होता। तो सैफरन के लिए तो आप जिम्मेदार हैं, हमें क्यों जिम्मेदार ठहरा रहे हैं?
निलंजन मुखोपाध्याय वांट्स टू कम इन ऑन आई थिंक अ कपल ऑफ पॉइंट्स बिकॉज यू आल्सो रिटन टुडे दैट Sushmita, I'll just come to you, give me a second, that Modi and Amit Shah will have to redouble their efforts to delegitimize the opposition. You believe that actually it's going to be tougher for the BJP than what most people think?
Yes, it will be tougher. I'll explain as to why I think that it will be tougher. But before that, just to add to this entire thing, SP, BSP, talking about Bihar, you know, unlikely alliances have a certain history in India, provided there is a overarching common enemy. Anti-Congressism used to be the driving force for opposition politics for decades. Tyagi ji would, we have learnt about anti-Congressism from Tyagi ji, as very young reporters. Today, anti-Congressism has been replaced by anti-BJPism. So, to defeat the BJP, parties, all kinds of unlikely parties are going to come together. Having said that, I just want to say that at the moment, I think that there is only one party which thinks in terms of getting a majority on its own, and that is, Ijaz would love it, me saying it, it's the BJP. Barring it, I don't think any party, even the Congress, is thinking of getting a majority on its own. So I think everybody is basically, KCR when he says, he's basically trying to revive the spirit of 1996, create a situation where nobody has enough number of seats to be able to form, and then somebody from outside gets supported by all kinds of parties to keep the BJP out, just the way that various United Front governments got together to keep the BJP out after the Vajpayee government fell off 13 days. So this is what is happening. Now, the problem that Mr. Modi is going to face in 2019, he is going to face multiple anti-incumbencies. The novelty period for Mr. Modi being a new item on the showcase of Indian politics is over. Everybody has tasted him. Everybody has sampled him. Everyone has opinion, whether it is good or bad, that he's done good work or is this bad work. So that thing is over. So the other parties are basically going to build on the capacity, the failure or the of the central government or of the state governments or on what they have done in their areas. Mamata Banerjee is going to talk about what she has done. KCR is going to talk about what she has done. Chandra Babu similarly, if he parts way, he is going to do the same thing. So I think 2019 is moving into an area where we expect that the first move in terms of really framing of issues has to come from Mr. Modi and the BJP. When I talk about delegitimizing, I think that the only way he can do it is by, making the Congress a butt of jokes, just the way it was in 2014. He actually ended up, sarcasm in 2014 turned out to be his most potent weapon. But he doesn't have sarcasm because now the sarcasm is stinging on him. You just have to go and actually ask the people, "Achhe din aaye," and then wait for the people to say, "Nahi aaye." So all that the Congress or the other opposition parties have to do is go back with the same promises. Have you got this? Have you got this? There is this problem that it is very difficult to deliver what you promise. So the natural advantage in terms of natural,
he will be judged on his performance as Prime Minister.
Unless he creates an issue which goes beyond these issues and, much more a nationalistic idea.
All right. Yeah. Well, amazingly, I have run out of time even on this, although it's been so great to talk about this. I think there'll be very interesting days ahead. Will there be a front without the Congress? We'll have to wait and see. There'll be all kinds of political alliances that will come up, the most unlikely political partners that will be thrown together. Certainly the SP and the BSP is someone you'd normally never think of coming together. Thank you to all of you for joining us. We'll